selling. You well. Not finished yet. I've been waiting for your return. I've decided to leave the Round Table Hold after all. As I mentioned, I'm off in search of the Noble Gold Mask. We may not meet again for some time. If there's any incantations you wish to learn, now's the moment. May the Golden Order shine. Ah.
Journey to the capital, let
the two things
you may be. Journey to
the two things
you may be our best. Is that potion what I think it is? Bloody Celibus. I suppose he's up to something again. Oh, I won't interfere. You go ahead and do what you must. The Round Table has no code to speak of. But I ask you this. Are you really going to do the bidding of that twisted dolly botherer? Or would you rather hand that potion to me and see if we can't get one over on the bastard? Good. I'll dispose of the potion myself. You go and see Celibus, but don't give anything away. Just tell him that you tricked your mark into drinking the potion, as planned. Despite knowing next to bloody nothing, he's so far up his own arse he won't suspect a thing. His inevitable display of arrogance will certainly be a sight to behold.
Have you ever felt the curse? With your whole being, the pox upon life itself, feared and despised by all. The reviled blessing. Apparently not. You are but a lamb, a stranger to defilement, ignorant of your own ignorance. You no longer interest me. I've been long without peace. Don't spoil my quietude. I asked you not to disturb me. Be thankful of the hold serenity. It is all that keeps your death and defilement at bay.
Always good to see you, son. What? Maybe I should tell you. Lately, I feel I'm on the precipice of falling into a deep, fathomless slumber. And I have an inkling it could spell trouble for you somehow. So I just wanted to get the apology out of the way beforehand, since you're so scary and all.
Greetings, are you here for I need to warn you about something. A little while ago, someone started lurking in the wing on the opposite side of the Round Table. And I can hear, from all the way over there, the howling and wailing of spirits in fear of a curse. I can even hear the repulsive twisted malice in itself. A plethora of spirits in an unceasing cacophony. I can't even imagine. How much suffering inflicted to who knows how many souls. Not even the grafting caused anything like this to happen. You should keep your distance. I know you're strong, but please. I feel like I'm really coming to grips with spirit tuning of late. I can see how and why immortal essence exists. A spirit under the Golden Order. I can understand their yearnings, what they become drawn to. Master Hugh said it himself, actually, that I'm no mere prentice any longer. Once again, I'm pleased to make your acquaintance, Roderica, the Certified Spirit Tuner.
Well, I took you for no matter it. Lay out your arm. The girl has come a long way. As ever, time and technique have made her stronger. 'Tis good to see. An imprisoned monster does not deserve an apprentice or a daughter, but at times that's precisely what she feels like to me. I've gone soft. And it isn't easy.